Hello, welcome to another Aggies Beers, Wines and Spirits review. On an absolutely boiling day, it is absolutely boiling. So, let me just have to go and get some new glasses. New glasses, please. So today I'm going to review this fella, Aspall's Premier Cru Cyder. An elegant extra dry cider with a light floral aroma and a strength of 6.8%. And I told the wife I was doing an alcohol-free review. Yeah, it's a good thing I don't lie. So, packed up at half a day today. And, what a lovely half day it's been, until about half an hour ago. We've been to a few shops, getting the some barbecue stuff ready for tomorrow, having a bit of a barbecue for my birthday. Can't go to a restaurant to have steaks, so steaks on the barbecue it is. And I'm coming home and there's the awful noise coming from the back wheel. Well, from the car. As we're driving along, pulled over, checked all the car, couldn't see anything, got back in, still do that. It's grating. I thought, bloody hell was that? Bounce everything. In the end, end up phoning the father-in-law because he dabbles with cars. He's come down. Got him with him, pulled so far, he heard something, he's jumped out and he's rattling the bloody exhaust on the back, the guard over the exhaust, because sometimes they make a noise. I've had that before on my Astra, end up taking the guard off, the heat guard, and can't find it. Then shortly after that, drove all the way home, no noise at all, so God knows what it was. But for somebody who stresses and full of anxiety, it is not the thing you want to be hearing. So nice, straw coloured pour, good lacing around the edge, no head, but then again, you won't really get a head on this. Oh, for God's sakes. Every website's got no submit preferences. Close. View site, here we go. Oh, now they want you. Oh, 1/1/1971. Yeah, that's it. I only wanted to get to the bit just to see the story about it. So, on the nose. Quite a subtle apple aroma on the nose. A nice dry apple taste. That's all I'm getting at the moment anyway. So it says here, the first cider produced by Barry and Henry Chevalier Guild when they joined the business 7 years. Oh, 7 years in creation and still their favourite drink. Premier Cru is a sophisticated sparkling cider with a light floral aroma and a long dry finish. Well, I can get a hint of floral, but it's a hint, it's not too strong. Crafted at the original cider house in Suffolk. Serving suggestion, delicious with roast pork, garlic and sage, chilli con carne, rogan josh, red Leicester and white Stilton. I do like a drop of Stilton, I've got to admit. One thing it is, it's nice, it's refreshing, and it just hits the spot after being in that sun for hours. And I'm already contemplating having another shift around in the garden and moving some of the moving at least one or both the sun loungers up onto that area underneath my gazebo where we've got escape, you know, where we can sit in the shade. Because obviously this time of the year, the sun, yes, it's lovely, but you can be cooked in it, and at the moment it's cooking. I mean, like a prat, I've got long trousers on, jeans on, and it ain't the weather for jeans, it's shorts weather. So trip up to the house after this and get some shorts on. Got to take some bottles of rosé, white wine, lager, and one of my red ale beers up to the house. Get it in the fridge and get it chilled, ready for a barbecue tomorrow. But also keep it stood up, because what I don't want is it, you know, if there's sediment, I don't want the sediment to get mixed. So I'd rather keep it. And I want to take the red ale up the house because I've got loads of it left. But you know, if you chill beers, especially bottle fermented beers, if you chill them, they don't explode, which is a trick a couple of people on the channel have actually told me. So thanks to that. So that's what I'll be doing, especially for the red ale, because it's liable to blow. There she goes, blow she goes. See now, the lager that I made is a nice lagery colour, and it's solid. So it should produce a nice fizzy lager. The wife's going to add lemonade to it anyway. All she wants it for is a shandy. So I get to brew something. And I'll obviously drink some of it, but it's funny, I've actually done three brews, all aimed at her and her friends. So I'm not a bad husband after all, you know. And tomorrow, I'll be doing the cooking on the barbecue. So birthday or not, I'll still be doing the cooking. What a long day. So last night, mate came round. Dropping stuff off for my son because he works with him. Had a couple of bottles of wine, red wine, and went in the hot tub after that. And I'd already reviewed a lager, so I reviewed Tyski last night. I reviewed some sparkling water, and I reviewed another beer. That hasn't gone up, so that's going to go up. About the same time as this, probably. Do two, bang two up in one go. We had two bottles of wine between us, red wine. Proper red wine, well, not the homebrew. And, yeah, he was honoured. 11 quid's worth of wine there. Although I've saved myself a glass of each for reviewing purposes. Which I'll have to neck tonight so that the father-in-law don't come and try any tomorrow. But, yeah, I went in the hot tub afterwards and fell asleep in the hot tub, didn't I? Gone. Obviously mixing the red wine, pint of lager, well it was more than a pint, and that. And obviously the sun, totally got me. So this is suitable for coeliacs, vegetarians and vegans, but it does contain sulfites. I always thought vegetarians and vegans didn't like anything with sulfites in, so. Strange that. Oh, quite nice. I understand now what it's saying. It's got an elegant taste to it. And it has. It's quite a refined cider. More of a traditional cider, as all apple ciders generally are, anyway. And the good news now. The pubs are reopening from the 4th of July. It doesn't affect me in any way, slightest form, because I'm not really a pub goer. But it's good to see things reopening again and, you know, life for the people that didn't die returning to some normality. And now, obviously, the country now is in place. We're in place for a second wave where you don't really have to lock down, not the whole country at least, lock down areas. And lockdown communities, and this is where communities that go to churches, that mass congregate, those sort of communities need to be very aware that they're the first ones that could, you know, be the first people to say you're gonna have to all lock down. Anybody that went to a certain party, lockdown 2 weeks. I'm quite lucky in a lot of ways because my family bubble, friends bubble and work bubble are all relatively very small. And obviously when you go shopping, you still do the washing your hands, sanitising, wiping all your stuff down that you bring home, sanitising anything that's foreign to your house. I mean, I even sanitise all beer bottles, because obviously you never know. You just don't. I mean, the funny thing is, we could have all had it and not even know we've had it. A bit strange when it starts hitting some of the countries who've got no health systems, because they're the countries that are going to get slaughtered. So a little thing that I picked up on today on the news, somebody flew an aeroplane over the Burnley and Man City match, and it had White Lives Matter on. And there's a big hoo-ha on the BBC, which are very Labourist, news platform, saying that the police are investigating it for racism, and Burnley are now saying they won't allow any flights over their stadium. And there's a big hoo-ha about it. Now, let's be fair, all lives matter. Not just whites, not just blacks, not just Asians, ethnicities. Every life matters. And maybe that, you know, instead of just saying black lives matter, because in a lot of ways, you're stoking racist fire. Yes, what happened in America was really bad. I mean, the bloke himself was no angel, and you've seen it in the papers, his crime record. He was no angel. Didn't deserve what he got, obviously. Although if it had been a fucking paedophile and that had happened, would people, you know? And yet, you know, every life matters. Now, there's a thing with that terrorist in London, that Libyan who's stabbed and killed them three people. There's no mass protest anywhere. You know, three people slaughtered. Three people have done nothing wrong. Not been pulled over for doing anything, robberies or anything. Just totally innocent. Now, all the bandwagon jumpers, and there's a lot of bandwagon jumpers in this country who jump on bandwagons, need to take a big look at what's happening in the world. And terrorism should not be happening, you know. And the slaughter of the innocents shouldn't be happening. I'd love to see where the BBC stand on this today, you know, because they, to me, are the biggest shit stirrers going at the moment. It's the way they slag off the Conservatives. I mean, I'm no Conservative fan. I'm not a fan of them. I actually like what Boris Johnson's done. I like the way he talks. And I've got actually like Matt Hancock. I think he does a good job. But, you know, there's far too much bandwagon jumping in this country. You know, you sow the seeds. All this at the moment, there was a thing on Facebook where four policemen were walking, and armed policemen, I don't know where they were from, what country they were in. And they were there, and somebody on the phone, oh shit, look at this, oh shit. And then all of a sudden, the person behind the camera, Black Lives Matter. And the policeman turns around and says, all lives matter. Which they do. No, they don't. No, they don't. And you're thinking, so you're saying only your lives matter, only black lives matter, no other lives matter. That is racist to everybody else of every other colour in the world. You know, we can't be going down that road, because that sets up a dangerous precedence, and that sets up racism, you know. We live in a times, an infuriating world where and then they wonder why stuff happens. It really does. But anyway, back to the beer. It's been 14 minutes in. Yes. I meant to do another review last night, but obviously I fell asleep, got drunk, fell asleep, and went to bed early, fell asleep early. Didn't even get bollocking off the wife, so. It's my birthday, she's not bollocking me at the moment. Although if I do anything really bad, I'll get the bollocking, don't you worry. And I'm sat here in this beer room, and I'm absolutely sweating my bejesus off. This is helping, but nice dryness of the mouth. Definitely getting a more fruity flavouring with this now. There's apple there, but it tastes... The flavours of the apple are bursting out. And it's a really palatable cider. 6.8%, around about £2.25 a bottle, I think, anyway, from Sainsbury's when I bought it. I'm sure it was Sainsbury's. Obviously, every supermarket's different. And also, you may have seen this on another review, but last night I was doing a review and I got a message from Bocksteen Brewery, and I've revealed the name now. And basically, they were running a competition, and if you look on Facebook, you'll see it anyway, and you'll see my name, Billy Wack. But anyway, they were running a competition to name a new beer that they're producing. And I've tried these ones before, naming beers. It's not easy, you know. And I had to put the new normal, because I thought, this is the new normal at the moment, anyway. And funnily enough, I won the competition, so they're sending me a case of mixed beers. I don't know if it's a case of totally mixed beers, or where you get two or three, and a box of 12. God knows what it is. I mean, I don't know, but that's great. You know, it's like an additional birthday present. And then I let them know, obviously, that I do beer reviews. So, with any luck, they might make it loads of random beers that they do, not just the core range. Because obviously, for me, it's all new reviews and free. And yeah, it's great to win a competition, because let's be fair, there's a lot of competitions on Facebook. And you do wonder sometimes if it's off, if the competitions are fake and that. Although over the years I have some nice stuff. I mean, I won a soul bucket from Bargain Booze. Shipyard t-shirt, like I've said on another review. A couple of crates of beer, one from Robinson's, one from St. Peter's. So it's worth entering competitions. The ones where you have to share are a bit more annoying, because then you have to try, and after the competition's ended, you need to go back into your Facebook and delete the competition. But half the time I just leave it on. So, very much enjoying this. I didn't get the fruit, the floral aroma as much. I got a hint of floral, but I must admit, I must say it was a hint. But the taste of the apple got better as you gone down the glass, as it should, because obviously you're washing your palate with the apple. And yeah, for me, quite a nice cider, good strength as well, 6.8%. I better not drink hotels for a while. That was lovely. Really nice, strong cider. You know, 6.8 is a good strength. So out of five then. Yeah, like I've already said. Straw colour poor, good lacing. No head, obviously. On the nose, very apple. Subtle apple. The slightest hint of floral, slight. On the taste, it got better as it went down. All different apple flavours coming through. And like it says, elegant. There was a more refined taste to it. And very pleasing, you know, along the way. Out of 5, 4.4 out of 5. Yeah, it was nice. And that's it for this beer review. I hope I haven't bored you silly too much. There's going to be quite a few beer reviews over the next day or two. Because while I'm doing beer reviews, but I'm also going to be doing beer haul videos. Because no doubt, I already know what I've got in the house. I've got 20 odd beers from the East Midlands that I got from adventurebeer.com. But I'm expecting that other box to come, and God knows what the kids have got me. So, all good. And, the beer wall will be ever stocked even more. I might have to use the beer floor soon to stock the beers and run a load of beers down the bottom just to get rid of the stockpile. But hey-o. It's all good. Also, all good for the future. Good future beer reviews. And I do like trying different stuff, not just beers, spirits, lagers, ciders, real ales. You know, homebrew. So it's all going to be good. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Stay safe. And thank you for subscribing, as always. Cheers.